Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make this scanner effect. So if I press the E key, a scanner comes out and you can see this creature with the highlights and outlines like this. And here, if I look at this creature, you can see that I can see it in outlines only. And here, I can see the creature in highlights only. So I can even see this through walls or trees like this. And you can do a lot of customization with this. And also, these different effects can also be controlled using a blueprint. So you can change it with some different events. So in order to select whether it has outlines or highlights, you can just change the custom stencil value. So if I change this stencil value to 2, it will only have highlights. And if I change that value to 1, it will have both the highlight and the outline. You can also control these values using a blueprint. Now you can also control a lot of parameters also. So here I can control the outline color to green. And I will change the screen color to green also. And I will change the highlight color to blue. And now I will change the edge color to purple. And also I will just increase the width of the outlines to 2. Now if I click apply, now you have a totally different scanner. So now it looks like this. And now it will also work on any kind of meshes, both organic and artificial. So here you can see that I can see object through the rocks. So you can kind of control that distance. So if I change this distance to 500 and click play, you won't be able to see the outlines unless you get very close. So here even then it is invisible. So I will just change this value to like 2000. So now it is visible, but if I just run far away, so now it is invisible. So as I get closer, it will be visible. So you can also get a different type of effect. So if I just change the highlight color to black and the outline color to black, and I will change the opacity to 1. And I will change both the screen color and the edge color to black. So now I will change the outline color to like a red color. So now you can get an effect like this. And also, if I just change the outline color to 0, and I will change the highlight color to 1, so it will be white. Now I can get an effect like this. And now, if I go here and change this custom stencil value to 0, and I will just change the highlight color back to 0. And I will change the screen color to 0 also. Now if I press play, now you can get the creature like this, isolated from the world. So I will also change the width of the outline to 0. And I will just bring this up a bit from the grass. Now if I press play, so now you can get this creature isolated from the world like this, and you can use this for a screenshot or something like that. So here you can see that when I press the E key, the camera is kind of shifting and this screen is kind of growing like this. This is done using the material. So I will be showing you how to do that also. So if you want to download the entire project files, you can support me on my Patreon. And for $5, you can download this and almost all the project files from my previous tutorials from there. The links will be in the description below. Check that out also. And thank you very much if you want to support me. So to create this, first we need to create a material. So for that, right click, then material. Then I will call this M size scanner, then open it up. Then change the blend mode to translucent. It will only work with translucent meshes. And change the shading model to unlit. Then pick two-sided, since we want to see the scanner from both the sides. So now first we need to create the sci-fi UI of the scanner. For that we can use a texture from the starter content. We can also create your own texture for it. So I will go to the texture folder. Then I will just bring in this tech panel. Then if I open this tech panel, and if I go to the alpha, you can see a texture like this. So here I will change this to preview on a cube. And if I want minus this alpha, we need a sci-fi texture like this. So this is what it looks like on a plane. So now I will just create a scalar parameter by pressing and holding S and clicking. And I will call this opacity. So this will control the overall opacity of our material and connect it to opacity. So now if I click apply, and if I just bring in a plane, and I will just set this to movable, so that we don't really need to rebuild the lighting for just this plane. So now I will just change the X axis to 2. So here I will just untick this lock, and I will change the X axis to 2. So we get a rectangle like this. I will just rotate this 90 degrees. And here you can see that from this side it is invisible, but from this side it is visible. But here we made our material two-sided. So if I just apply this, I will just create an instance and apply the instance, and I will open the instance up, and I will change the opacity to 1. So now you can see that it is visible from both the sides. So in order to get this texture, we can go here and we can just multiply this opacity with this, and we can just connect this to the opacity and untick this. Then we will get a vector parameter by pressing and holding V and clicking. And we will call this UI color. So this will give the color to the UI. So if I connect this and click apply, and if I change this to red or something like that, we can get an effect like this. So here we kind of need to stretch this in this direction, in the horizontal direction. So we will just go here and type in scale UV by center, and we will connect the UV here, and we will just press and hold 2 and click. So we get this 2 vector. It will allow us to control it in the horizontal axis and also the vertical axis. So connect this to texture scale, and now change the R value to 1 and the G value to 1.35, then click apply. So now we get something like this. If you want the opposite effect, you can just go here and change the G value to 1 and the R value to 1.35 and click apply. So now we get something like this. Now to get the scan lines through the screen, you can either create your own texture for that or just use some texture from the starter content like this water texture and kind of scale it in a way that it resembles some lines. So I will just bring it into the world. And now one thing is that you don't really need to connect this to the opacity. So if you have a high enough value for the MSC color, like if we multiply this with this texture, you don't really have to multiply it with the texture here. So I will show you what I mean. So if I click apply now, and here you can see that the black is still visible, but if I go back and just get a layer and connect this to alpha and connect this to B and connect this to the MSC color now and click apply. And now if I reduce the alpha like this, you can see that we get a screen like effect like this with the black color. Now to give the screen a color, we can get a vector parameter and call the screen color. Then if I connect this to the MSC color, and now if I connect this to the layer and click apply, you can now control the screen color like this. So if you reduce the value of this screen color, it will be less visible like this. So in order to get lines from this texture, we need to stretch this in one direction and kind of shrink it in the other direction. So get a UV coordinate by pressing and holding U and clicking, and now get a multiply node and connect this here and connect this to the UV, and again get a 2 vector. And now I will change the R value to 0.1 and the G value to 5. Now I will get a panner, and now I will just pan it downwards by giving a value of -2 for Y speed. Now I will just multiply the screen color with the red channel because we need the grayscale value. And now if I connect this to the A of the layer and click apply, we can get an effect like this. So now if we just increase the color value, it will be more visible. So if you want to make it go downwards, you can either just rotate this 180 degrees or change the panner to positive 2 here. So now we have our screen setup ready. Maybe we can just change the R value to 0.01. So now we get something like this. So now I will just select all of this and comment and call this UI, and I will just bring it over here. Now to make the growing and shrinking of the screen. So for that, first we will get the actor position. Then we will get a subtract. And now I will get the world position. And I will connect this to here. So now if I connect this to the world position, our mesh will collapse to its pivot point. So if I click apply, you won't be able to see our mesh. So now in order to control the growth and shrinking of the mesh, we can get a layer and connect this to B and connect this to the position. And we will get a scalar parameter called alpha and connect this to the alpha, and we will clamp this between 0 and 1 and click apply. Now our mesh is visible. But if I change this to 1, it will be invisible. So you can see that it is growing and shrinking like this. So we can use this to animate our mesh. So later we will be changing this actor position to the position of the object. So we can get an effect like this. So it looks like it is growing from the hand of the player. So later we will do that. So now I will just comment this and call this animation. Now to isolate the mesh from the world using custom depth, right click and type in scene texture, then change this to custom depth. Then here we will just mask this component mask, and we just need the red channel. Now we will divide this and we will get a scalar parameter. We will call this distance. This value controls how far away from the screen we will be able to see the objects, highlighted objects. So I will change this value to 5000. Now I will get an if node. Now I will just get a constant value by pressing and holding 1 and clicking. And I will change this value to 0.5. And I will connect this to B. And I will get another scalar parameter. And I will connect to A greater than B. And I will get another scalar parameter. And I will call this 1. Then I will connect this to A less than B. And now I will connect this to the MC color and click apply. So now here you can see that all the objects with the custom depth is highlighted in white color. So if I just bring in a sphere like this and I will go to the custom depth. So it is already white color, so nothing changes. So I will just apply some material to it, like this walnut texture. So now you can see that it is walnut, but I will just type in custom in the search and render in custom depth. Now you can see that it has a white mask. So this is what we want. Now we have essentially masked out the meshes with the custom depth using this. So I will just select all of this and comment this custom depth mask, and I will just move it here like this. Now we will create the outline for the effect. So to create outlines, we have to compare the depth of the object and its background, and if the difference in the depth value is very high, we will draw outlines around it. If you want to get more information about it, watch my outlines tutorials. So to get the outlines, first we will get a sample scene depth node. So type in sample scene depth. Then here we need to get a boolean static bool. So and now we will just set this value to true, because we need to use the scene depth, because we are going to mask it using the scene depth. So we will set that to true. Then we will get a 2 vector by pressing and holding 2 and clicking. Then I will just connect this here. This is for the center pixel. And here we also need to multiply this value by the kernel value for outline, which is -4. Now, since this is the center, we need to get the top, bottom, left and right values. So for that, we will just duplicate this. And I will just disconnect the pixel offset. And here I will type in blur sample offset. So this will give us the top direction. So if you open this up, you can see that it has coordinate like this. So this will give us the top direction. And now I will just duplicate this. And I will connect this to here. This will give us the left direction, and so on. I will connect this here, and I will connect this here. So we have all four directions and the center. Now we have to add them together. So I will just add this depth using pixel offset here, here, and here. Then I will add this also. Then I will add this to this one. Now, in order to control the thickness of the outlines, we will get a multiply node. So this multiply is to control the amount of outlines. So we will get a scalar parameter, and I will call this multi, and I will connect this to B. And now I will get a power node, and I will get a scalar parameter, and I will call this POW for power, and I will connect this to the exponent. Now here we can get a scalar parameter, and this will control the thickness of our outline. So I will call this thickness. Now connect this here. Now get the absolute value, since we also need to convert the negative values to a positive value here. Now we will just clamp this. So we don't want our values going above or below 1 and 0. Now I will just comment this outline. And now if I connect this to the MSC color and click apply. And now if I go to the instance, and here I will increase the multi value to 2 and the power value to 2 and the thickness value to 2 also. So we have these outlines. So now if I increase the power to 100 and the multi to like 1 or 0.9, and I will increase the power again, so it doesn't change much. So I will change the thickness to 1. So now we have a clean outline. I will change the multi to 2 or 1. So we got outlines like this. So now we have our outlines. So I will just disconnect this and bring it over here. Now to mask the object using the stencil value, keep in mind that you have to enable that in the project settings. So if you go here and type in stencil and just change this to enable with stencil, now you can go back to the material. Now here I will just type in scene texture, and I will change this to custom stencil. Now here, and now here I can go to the color, and I can just component mask this, and just the R value. We just need the grayscale value of this stencil. Now we will get a node called bit mask. Then here, so here you can see that our bit value is kind of divided by 255, because we can input 256 unique values to this, including 0. So if you need to mask this, we need to divide this by 255 also. So both these values will be equal, and we are comparing them. So if this value, if the bit mask value is equal to the bit value, then we will get an one output, and if it isn't, we will get a zero value. So here I will connect this to the bit mask. So for the bit, right now I will just get a scalar parameter, and I will call this bit, and I will connect this to the bit mask. And if I connect this to the MSC color and click apply, now I will go to the map, and here I can select this sphere, and I will just duplicate this. And now I go to the instance, and I will change the bit value to 1. So now you can see that both of them are like this. And if I just select this sphere and change the custom stencil value to 1, it will be masked out. And if I change this bit value to 2, it will be normal again. But now if I change the custom stencil value to 2, it will be masked out again. So with this custom stencil, we can kind of mask out 256 unique objects. So now I will just delete this bit and get a constant value and change this to 1, and I will just duplicate this. and change the constant value to 2, and I will just comment all of this and call this custom stencil mask. Then I will just bring it here and I will just disconnect this. Now we will put all of them together. So I will get a layer and I will just connect this to A, and now I will just connect this to the MSC color, and I will just connect this to the alpha here, and now I will get a vector parameter and I will call this highlight color. And I will connect this to B and I will click apply. And here I will change the highlight color to red. So you can see that everything is being highlighted. So now we need to draw outlines and also separate this using the custom mask. So to do that, I will just disconnect it right now and I will get a layer and I will connect this to the B here, and I will get another layer and one more layer, and now I will connect this to A and I will connect this to A here, and for the mask here I will just connect the second stencil mask, and here I will connect the first stencil mask. And here for the alpha I will connect the outlines, then I will get a vector parameter and I will call this outlines outline color. And here for A I will get a scene color, then connect this to A, and here I will get another layer and I will connect this to the B, and now I will get a Fresnel node. So this is to give the highlight little bit more details. Then I will get a scene texture node, so right click and type in scene texture, and I will change this to a world normal. And I will just mask this. And now I will just compound and mask this. And we also need to tick the B value and connect this to the normals. And for the exponent, I will get a scalar parameter and I will call this exponent. And I will connect this here. And I will connect this to the alpha. And I will connect this to the highlight color. And I will connect the outline color to B. And now if I change the exponent to 2. And I will connect this to the MSC color and click apply. Now you can see that there is some detail on our sphere. So here I will change this color to like red or something like that. And now I will change the outline color to 22 and 2. And I will just reduce the value of the highlight color like this. And now I can increase the exponent value to get an effect like this, or reduce it to get something like this. So now I will just connect this to the MSC color, and here we are actually supposed to connect the outlines to the alpha, and the value from the Fresnel should be multiplied with the highlight value like this. And now connect this to the B of the multiply. And now connect this to B also. And now for the B value, this LUT, we need to connect the multiply here like this. So now if I click apply, we get something like this. And now I will just select this. So here we are supposed to connect this to the A of this LUT, because the one value will be the outline value. So the outline color should go to B like this. So now this is what it looks like. We are adding the Fresnel to get some details, and we are multiplying this with the highlight color, and we connect that to the A of the LUT here. And here it is also connected to the B of this LUT. Since here in this LUT, this alpha value will be 1 if the bit mask value is 2. So we need to connect that to B here. So now if I click apply, so here you can see that this doesn't have any outlines because it has a bit mask value of 2. So if we go to the instance, and here we can increase the exponent value to 2. We can also increase the color value like this. So now we can get a highlight like this. And I will just increase the decrease exponent to 1. So we get highlight like this. And if I change this to 10, we only have little highlights. So I will change this to like 2 or something like that. And here this has a custom stencil value of 0, so it is completely outlines. If I change this to 1, it will be outline and the highlight. So now here I can change the outline color like this, and I can change the power of the outlines to 100 or like 50, and change the multi value to 2 or 1.5, and I will just reduce the outline color intensity to like 50, and I will change the value to an orange color like this. We can also change the highlight color. Now I will just duplicate this again, and here you can see that we have a custom stencil value of 2. I will change this to 0, so it will be just outlines, and I will change this to 1, so it will be outlines and highlights. And if I change this to 2, it will be just the highlight and no outline will be present on that, like this. So we got our 3 effects. So here we can see that the object is kind of drawing over the sci-fi UI element. So in order to fix this, we can go to the material, and now here we can just add a reroute node here by double clicking, and we can just get a multiply and connect this here and connect this here and connect the alpha to the multiply like this. And now if I click apply, now you can see that it is in drawing over the sci-fi UI element. So if you want to add more colors and more outlines, you can just add more masks here and just lerp them like this. So now I will give an overview of how to integrate this with your character blueprint. So first thing we have to do is we need to delete this actor position and get a vector parameter and call this location. So we can set this in our blueprint. So now we need to go back to the blueprint, and now we need to add a plane like this. So if you want to see this, you just have to change the alpha value to 1. So this is the alpha value that is controlling the growth and shrinking of the mesh. So here change the alpha value to 1 for previewing, so we can preview a mesh like this. So just add a plane mesh like this and add our material instance that we have created. Then go to the event blueprint. Then here we will get an E key event, then a flip flop. Then I am just setting the walk speed when I press E key. So when I am scanning the world, the walk speed will be slower. And when I am not scanning the world, it will be faster. Then I have a timeline here. So if I open it up, so here I have a flow track called alpha here. Just add a flow track like this. Then it is going from 0 to a value of 1 at the time when the time is equal to 1. So at time equal to 0, the value is equal to 0. And at time equal to 1, the value is equal to 1. The length of the timeline is also 1. So you can see that it is kind of moving this wavy pattern. That's why we have this bouncy effect when it is coming up like this. So just create a wavy curve like this. Then we will go to the event graph. Then here we will set our vector. So before that, we need to go to the event begin play and just get the plane mesh like this, drag it in and create a dynamic material instance and set this to a variable like this. So right click, then promote to variable. Then here we can just drag that in like this, get the variable. Then from here we can set vector parameter value and change the parameter value to location. So the location is this location vector parameter. So just add that here. And from there, we need to get the arrow location. So this arrow is kind of located here. So this is the position at which the character's arm appears when we animate it. I will cover the animation a bit later. So we will just add an arrow here. And just when this timeline updates, we just get the arrow's world location and pass it through the material to the location parameter here like this. So we are just giving the location of the arrow to the scanner. Then we will also drag from the scan effect and set parameter value. And here we have a set scalar parameter value. This controls the alpha value of this. This controls this alpha value here. So it is driven by this alpha timeline track. So this flow track, so it kind of goes up, then decrease and up, then it is set to 1, which gives us our bouncy effect. So that is passed through this. And this is a hand blend. So I will cover this later. Then lastly, I have this camera movement effect like this. So I have added two arrows like this. So if I press play, and if I press the E key, you can see that when I press E, the camera is kind of moving closer to the character. So in order to get that, I have two arrows like this. So this will just store the initial position of the camera. And this is the secondary position. So I'm just getting the camera world transform here. And also the second camera's world transform here. And I'm just using a lerp transform. And I will just connect this to the follow camera like this. And set world transform like this. And I will just connect this to the transform. So this alpha value is also controlled by the timeline track. So here, if I go to the camera track here, it is going from 0 to 1 like this. So this kind of blends the transformation of the camera from this arrow to this arrow smoothly. Now for the animation of the hand. So if I press play, you can see that when I press E, the hand is visible. So here you can see that when I press play, the screen is already visible. In order to fix that, we can go to the material and change the alpha value to 0. And now if I press play, and now you can see that it is invisible when you press play. So now to get the animation of the character, we will just open up the skeletal mesh and we will just go to the mesh. And now here with these controls you can just rotate the arms like this and create an animation like the one in the video. And after that you can just go here and create animation from current pose, and that's all you need to do. Then after that we have to go to the blueprint, and here we need to cast to third person character and get a sequence node here and connect this to get pawn owner. Then create a variable called blend hand here, like add this and add a variable like this. Then get a hand blend variable from the third person character. So we need to create the hand blend variable here, and we need to create a track in the timeline. So it goes from 0 to 1 with a time period of 0.3. So it goes from 0 at 0 to 1 at 0.3 time. So now it is a hand blend track. We will just connect that to the variable here and set this, and it is updated using the update of the timeline. And we will just call that to the blend hand variable here in the animation blueprint. Then we have to go to the animation graph. When you go to the animation graph, this is what you will see. So here we need to get a layered blend per bone node. So you can type in layered blend per bone, then just connect this to the base pose and connect this to the result, and then get the animation we have created. So this is the animation that I have created. So you can just drag that in, then connect this to the blend pose here. And here for the layered blend per bone, you need to change the bone name to spline. So you can see that when I press play, when I press E key, so the top of the body is kind of in this animation. And when we walk, we can actually walk and see the walking animation. So here what is happening is that everything below this spline bone, so if I go to the skeletal mesh and I select the spine, so everything below the spine bone, we can get the default animation, and everything above, we have this hand animation. And it is kind of blending this default animation to this animation using this blend value. So at a value of 0, it will be just the default animation. And when the value is 1, it will be this animation blended with this animation according to the bone name you provided here. So that's why we are getting this blended effect like this when I press E. And when I press E again, the value kind of goes from 1 to 0. So if the blend value is 1 now, when I press E again, it will be 0. So we will get our normal animation. So I think that's it for the tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching. And if you want to get the project files, you can support me on my Patreon.